In this section, you're going to go ahead and replace those strings in your return statements with templates. In your templates directory, make 8 new files with the following names. Replace the previous return statements such that they now return render templates for each of your methods in finalproject.py. But wait a second, if we design our templates before connecting to a database, Python will throw an error message when we try to refer to restaurants and menu items that don't yet exist in our application. To get around this problem, we can temporarily make a fake database out of dictionaries inside of our finalproject.py file. I have made some dictionaries, which will serve as dummy variables for one restaurant, a collection of restaurants, one menu item, and a collection of menu items. The source code for these dictionaries is available in the instructor notes. Go ahead and leave hashtags in the form action and hrefpath, since we are focusing more on the structure of our pages in this step, and not so much their functionality. Now, when a user revisits these links in a browser, they should see something like this. The functionality isn't going to be in place just yet, but we have just created another prototype that we can use to present our progress thus far. Your template should also return a different message to the user if there's an empty menu or empty list of restaurants. Maybe something like this. Try and see if you can accommodate for this corner case in your templates as well.